Hey guys, Brian here. Welcome back to the shop for the second time on this one. Whatever happened, camera screwed up anyway, footage got lost. Nevertheless, working on this little clutch hub for pulling tractor, and I've taken these two hubs and welded them together so that they function as one. And now I got to cut out in between so the spline disc can slide all the way over this. It's not a super critical kind of deal, just that they have clearance mainly for the splines to slide over. They're just stamped steel plates, so they're not super accurate anyway. They just got to be able to slide and not hang up. This drum's got wear too. To have a tractor with no telling how many thousands of hours. It's pulled a lot, and it's got notches wore into the surfaces, and somebody's grounding on this, and it's had some life. It could tell some stories, no doubt. So what I've done is ground up a form tool, since I don't have a involute cutter that matches this line profile, and I'm just going to shape them out here on the lathe. So I already turned down the OD, so it should be right. That was before I realized that the camera wasn't working right, so you missed all that. I ain't putting the material back on so you can watch it again. Sorry. So hopefully you can see I've got the back of this supported so it can't push back into the chuck. It'd have to be fairly far out in order to make these cuts. And then my tool's not long enough to catch all the screws, so I put this second one in. I've tightened it down to try and help keep this from having enough torque to twist and pivot on these screws. I got them as tight as I can get them, but it's a lot of force, so you can move them. Just got to keep an eye on that. Let's rotate to the next one here. And I can come in and it self-aligns. And I come down and make a cut. There you can see the cutter. See the weld? That one's not got a whole lot of weld. Knock it, we'll catch one of these later ones bigger. Well, it ain't beautiful, but it's probably better than a hand grinder. Yep, the splines are all cut through. Go trepan the center out of the other piece and we'll be ready to put this together. All right, I need to cut the center out of this plate. So I got my little round insert Schar's boring tool in there I'm gonna use for a trepanning tool and see if I can't plunge in here and halfway and then flip this thing around and do the other side. Thank you. it's flipped around. Let's go again. Put this clutch together. These ought to be soaked in oil, but I gotta ship this thing, so I'm not going to do that. I'm gonna bend the splines over a little on this disc because people have a tendency to let this hub back when they're pushing the tractor together. It's right here at the edge, so it'll fall off and get pinched in between. And when they pull the tractor together with the bolts, it takes the thrust bearing out of the engine. So this is a safety measure. Doesn't seem to hurt anything. And I'll do the trick. About all this stuff will fall when I flip this over, but that's what it is. That's it. Probably needs to be a little looser than that, but it's close. So I have to put this in the flywheel, and then there's a tool that bolts on here to set this finger height. So once they get it bolted up to a flywheel, they can adjust that and then lock these jam nuts down. But other than that, it's together. Shouldn't fall apart in shipping anyway. Look at all that multi-disc goodness. So, there it is. One completed 6-disc tractor pulling wet clutch. This all runs in oil. It's hydraulic actuated. So, this is like 4430, 4440 kind of stuff. And I rate these at 150 horse per disc. Is what I found is pretty reliable for what they'll withstand pulling. We're slipping them out of the hole and stuff. So this one here should be good for about 900 horsepower, which is good enough to take the high pinion out of the transmission running road gear. Usually that gives up about 850. So this here shouldn't be the problem. Should pretty well go all season without having to do anything to it, as long as they're not trying to run too much gear for the power I have and just slip the heck out of it and burn it up. If you get these plates warped, it'll get to where you can't get it in and out of gear. But if you drive it like you should, you shouldn't have any trouble. We know how race parts go. They're usually always some kind of trouble. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. I'll catch y'all later.